Hello, this is Michael Slapsky here for a very exciting Tip Tuesday. There's a brand new workflow in After Effects that's going to change things. This has certainly changed the way I've worked. I've just got a simple layer here with fractal noise applied at default and the circle effect applied with stencil alpha chosen as its little blending mode there, which means I can move this little thing around and just kind of reveal the layer where it's at. It's a very handy way of just adding a quick circle into things, but if I want to animate this position around, I'm stuck animating the effect position point, which is clunky and limiting. Brand new in the public beta of After Effects, any effect's position parameter can now be quickly tied to a null by right-clicking, going to Keyframe Assistant, Create Nulls for Position Points. I could grab this null, move it around, and it moves a circle with X position. You can separate the dimensions and animate it, you know, all the ways you like to animate things. So that's the basics of what it can do. Let me show you a couple of different ways you can apply it. I've got a circle effect here, but I've also applied Universe Spectralicious after it. And Universe Spectralicious is a 6-point gradient. And all 6 of the gradient's position points are tied to these nulls, which are turned 3D and then parented to this one. If I, let's say, rotate this one, I've got all my points rotating around it. And rotate this way, I've got all my gradient points are now rotating around in 3D space, almost. So that's kind of cool. But let me show you the thing that really makes me happy about this. In this composition, I've got a background layer here and this text layer with Universe Luster applied. And Luster has position points here in the source color for this gradient that gives it this kind of chromey look. A limitation in After Effects is that layers like text layers that are vectors, anytime you move a vector layer around, any effect's position points on it won't move around. They stay locked into the composition's position points because it's being continuously rasterized. That's just how it works. So if I wanted to animate this in, I lose the color of my gradient. It just kind of passes through it. But that's not what I want. Well, all I have to do, double click them to show them down here. And select both of them, right click, keyframe assistant, create nulls for position points, and boom, I now have these two nulls. All I have to do is parent them to this text layer, hit P for position, and now I can now animate this layer all I want, and the color knots stay locked to the layer just the way I want. It is going to make working with these kinds of effects so much easier, and I'm going to show you how to build this just in Universe. I've got this scene here of a couple of lights moving by some 3D text here, custom universe turbulence noise, and multitone make the background there. And I've got some chromatic aberration, kind of an adjustment layer. And then I'm going to put some universe, Knoll Light Factory EZ. I'm going to go to the natural light category and choose smudge lens. And I wanted this flare to follow the position of that light. Well, again, with the new feature in After Effects, light location, let's hit SS to solo that selection there. And I'm going to right click on it and say keyframe assistant, create nulls for positional points. And I've got a null, got an expression here that's gonna make it follow that null. I'm gonna turn that null 3D. Then I'm gonna use this parenting here and I'm going to hold shift while I drag the parenting pick whip over to the light and it will snap that null over to the light's position. Now you see what it's done is it's added the expression and it added this little layer dropdown expression selector effect here. So if I already named this null something like flare locator 1, and I want to have another flare that follows this light. I don't need to go through the process of right clicking and adding the keyframe stuff. I can just duplicate the flare and the flare locator. And for flare locator 2, I'm going to point it to the light 2, holding shift, it jumps it over there. Then for flare 2, I'm going to take this drop down and say flare locator 2, and automatically it jumps right to it. And just like that, I've got flares that follow the position of my After Effects lights using Knoll Light Factory EZ. And I'm so excited, it's in the public beta of After Effects right now. Download it, give it a try.